spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. Today we celebrate the memorial of St. Hilary, bishop and doctor known for his writing on the Trinity and his writing against Arians. So as we prepare ourselves today to enter into these sacred mysteries, let us begin by first of all to mind ourselves. Just draw our Lord have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may rightly understand and truthfully profess the divinity of your Son, which the Bishop St. Hilary taught with such constancy, for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Since the children share in blood and flesh, Jesus likewise shared in heaven, that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is the devil, and free those who through fear of death have been subject to slavery all their life. Surely he did not call angels, but rather the descendants of Abraham. Therefore he had to become like his brothers and sisters in every way, that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest before God, to expiate the sins of the people. Because he himself was tested for what he suffered, he is able to help those who are being tested. The word of the Lord. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name. Make known among the nations his deeds. Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all others that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on these offerings we set up on this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed St. Hilary, bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and with all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice together we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the death of the Lord until we come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Hilary, and with all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, not on our sins, but on the faith of your church," and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. It was not you who chose me, says the Lord, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, following the example of Blessed St. Hilary, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught. We ask this through